initially we'll go with our notepad. You know, we are talking about the critical examination, which is applied on the recorded observation of the method which is being used currently for doing a particular job. And this is applied using the like say primarily it involves the set of questions which are asked sequentially. These are like primary questions, okay, primary questions, and then it involves the secondary questions. Primary questions are primarily to challenge really what, where, when, who and how. These are the kind of questions are asked, and if we don't find a valid justification and answer for these, then we look for the possibility of elimination, rearrangement, combination or simplification. So these are the various possibilities which are explored if the activities or the place or the sequence can be clubbed, simplified, combined. So these questions are asked in that way. But for doing a particular thing, let's say, so this is in the primary questions we talk about like purpose, place, sequence, person and means. These are the five things about the question is asked. So there is a possibility like the purpose is redundant and it can be completely eliminated. Likewise, the place, sequence, person and the means also either can be clubbed. If the purpose is justified, then where it is being done, in which sequence it is being done, who is doing it and how it is being done. So then we can look for the possibilities of how it can be clubbed, combined, simplified, etc. Okay, but and that possibility is identified through the second stage questioning. So based on responses to the primary questioning, the secondary questions are imposed. So secondary questions are imposed, and then the responses about that is obtained or developed. It is not necessary that the owner of a particular step or the process will be responsible for this secondary stage questioning, but the method study person on its own may also have to come up with the possible alternatives or other options. So what it does in as far as the purpose is concerned, after asking what is being done and why it is being done, the questions in the so these are the primary set of the questions. What we ask like what else can be done. So for realizing this, like say for developing the flat surfaces, you can use milling or shaping. Likewise, for developing the cylindrical surfaces, you may use the turning, and after the turning may be rough and fine, thereafter the grinding. So for doing the same thing, there may be number of options. You know, in manufacturing, the same size product, size and shape products can be manufactured using number of other techniques, number of approaches. So we look for that this particular purpose which is being realized at a particular step is fine, but is there a possibility to realize the same using something else? So we look for the alternatives as far as the main objective of a particular step is concerned, if it is justified. So if we find what is being done and why it is being done, if the purpose is justified, then we look for the alternatives and the options. Say we get like four alternatives, A1, A2, A3 and A4. Then how to zero down on a particular option? So for that, again, we need some kind of the analysis. So what are the points that we consider while zeroing down on a particular option? That I'll talk about that a little later once we complete all these complete set of the secondary questioning. So what else can be done? And based on the analysis, we have to zero down on a particular option, and that will be giving from the response of like what should be done. So when we get the answer of what should be done, it is possible that we may come out with a different way of doing the things for realizing a particular purpose related with a particular step of the entire procedure. So this is one. If the procedure is justified and if the purpose is justified, and we have identified a particular way of doing the things, or if there is no other better alternative, then we'll continue to go with that only. Thereafter, the second question that will be asked is like where it is being done. So that's the place. Okay. So that's the place. So after asking like where it is being done and why it is being done at that particular place, what we have to ask, where else can it be done? This is the first. And then based on the again the some set of the methodology, systematic methodology of identifying how to come up with a particular place where it can be done. Now we have to see, we have to ask the another question related with this is like, say again we get the four different options of the different four different places, P1, P2, P3, P4. So we have to identify the one which will be the best for a given situation. And once so after analysis, we will be able to identify like where should it be done. Okay, so these two are the secondary questions. Likewise, these two are the secondary questions for related to the first. That is the purpose, and this is about the place. Okay, then we have the next one, where that is the sequence is the next aspect. So in the sequence, when should it be done and why should it be done at that particular movement or the time or at that particular sequence? After asking this, we'll be asking further like what else, no, where else it can be so. So the alternative like which other or else sequence or the movement can it be done, right? So after asking when and why these are justified, we'll be looking for other options like what will be the other the place or the sequence where it can be done, and then we'll be asking the second question like when should it be done. So this when should it be done is about like zeroing down on a particular sequence. So likewise, as I said, there may be two, three other sequential positions where it can be done. So you will zeroing down on a particular sequential position or particular movement or particular time when it should be done. Then about the person, like who will be doing this and why only this person, means as far as the skill level is concerned, like the semi-skilled, unskilled, or the skilled person. Or if after getting this response, we will further explore the possibility if this can be done by someone else as well. So who else can do it? Okay. And if you find, okay, there are two three possibilities as far as the persons are concerned, then we'll be zeroing down on a particular one. So that is what will be done, like by asking who should do it. Okay. So this is the second question related with the person, and the first question related with the secondary questioning, who else can do it. And then the means. So in the means, how it is being done and why it is being done using that particular tool or equipment or the system. Then as an alternative, we'll try to explore using the secondary questioning, like how else it can be done. How else can it be done? And let's say if you find the four different means, M1, M2, M3 and M4, then using a systematic approach, you may identify it should be cost effective, it should be safe, it should be user friendly, etc. And you can zero down on a particular option, and that will you can get from what, sorry, how should it be done. So this is the second question related with the secondary questions of the for the means. So that's how we get actually the four different questions for each of the heading, starting from, like, say, the purpose, place, sequence, person, and means. Okay, so what we are getting basically, what where, the first set, when, who, and how. Okay, yes, how, and then we ask why. Okay, and then again we ask what else and what should, like this, for each of these questions, like where else, when else, who else, and how else it can be done. Then what should be, where should be, when should it be done, who should do it, and how should it be done. So this is so the third part is about exploring the options only here. What else, or where else, when else, who else, and how else it can be done. This is about exploring the alternatives, or the options. And here the finalizing, the one option which is expected to give the desired results. So as I said, we at each in the secondary stage, we will be getting the certain options, and those options need to be one of those is to be finalized. So what we keep in mind while finalizing the option, we should see that when choosing the option, it should bring in the economy in terms of bringing down the resources being used, in terms of man, material, machine, or the time which is being used. At the same time, it should, whatever the option we choose in, that should ensure that the safety is not compromised. So no compromise with the safety of the workers, operators, or the supervisors, whosoever is working there in. The work quality is not compromised. Either there is a improvement in quality, or at least it is not compromised. So no compromise with the quality when efforts are being made to bring down the resources being used, or so as to bring the economy in for improving the productivity. And the last factor is the human factor. Also, we need to consider this human factor. It should not, whatever the option is being chosen, it should be easy to implement. That's one. And it should not unnecessarily lead to the exploitation of the human or the manpower which is there in. So that it is more user friendly. We have to see whatever the option is being chosen, that is user friendly, and therefore it will have the good acceptability. Otherwise, workers may come against the proposed changes. So whatever the alternative is being chosen, that should bring in the economy, should not compromise with the safety, it should improve the quality rather, or if not improving, then there should not be compromise with the quality, whatever is being manufactured or produced using the existing method, the same at least should be produced. And the human factor is also considered, so that the proposed methodology is user friendly, and so that it gets the more acceptability. Okay, so these were the way by which the second stage questioning is implemented. Now, using the earlier example, I'll try to show how it is implemented, and that in turn will be leading to the fourth step of the method study method. So development of the improved method. So as I said, this is about the secondary questioning only, what I have explained just now, the purpose. With regard to the purpose, if it is convincing, let's go it. Otherwise, look for what else can be done. Like, there is the means. It is not in sequence, but it should be in sequence only. So just do not follow this, because the purpose, then place, then sequence, then person, and then means. That's how it is done. But anyway, the meaning we can understand. Like, means, what else can be done as per the means is concerned. Where else can be done as far as the place is concerned. And in the sequence, where else it could be done. And then about the person, the possibility to carry out the activity by other persons is also explored, so that we can identify who else can do it. Okay, so this secondary phase involves the searching the alternative options within the imposed restrictions of the cost, volume, etc. You have to see that it doesn't go, it doesn't become, the suggested option doesn't become the uneconomical for the given the costing or the volume which is to be produced. And for this method study, man uses his own past experience and with the same or the similar kind of the problems. Okay, that's fine. Answer to the following questions are then sought through the evaluation of alternative, like what should be done, how should it be done, where should it be done, and when should it be done, and who should do it. So about this I have already talked. So these are like the complete set of the questions for the critical examination which are used. So the first two are the primary and second two are the secondary questions regarding the place, purpose, purpose, place, sequence, person, and the means. Okay, so about this I have already talked in detail and their meaning. As I was saying, we'll have to find out, we have to zero down on particular alternative, and that is done on the basis of the economy, safety, work quality and the human factor, so that in economic consideration whatever alternative is being offered, being chosen, it should be cost effective, economical, and the evaluating the safety factor is also important. It should not make the job risky, so the selected the option should not make the work less safe, and the evaluation of the quality factor also is evaluation of the quality factor is also done to see that if there is no compromise with the quality, rather the improvement in quality of the product takes place, that's for better. And then lastly, the human factor also is to be considered to see that the work is the new method is interesting, it is easy to learn, it is safe and not monotonous and causing the less fatigue, so it is more user friendly, you can say. So these are the points which are kept in mind when we are talking about the kind of how to zero down on particular option. Okay, this is basically the flow diagram, right? Flow diagram of the earlier example we have talked, that was related with the the bus engine was being lifted from the store, then it was being taken to the disassembling or dismantling bay. There it was disassembled, then it was cleaned, then inspected. Thereafter it was then degreasing was done. After that cleaning was done again, and then finally inspection was carried out. And for that there were 21 number of transports, and 4 operations, 1 inspection, 3 delays, something like this. Those were the details. Okay, maybe in next slide. Okay, so here if you see, these were the different activities. These were the different activities related with the bus engine inspection related. So the engine was picked up from a store, and then after various transportation, then dismantling, cleaning, degreasing, things were done, and it required a distance, total distance traveled was 375.5, and apart from that there were about 4 operations. So you can see here the 4 operations in the existing method: 21 transports, 3 delays, 1 inspection and 1 permanent storage. Total distance traveled was this one. Okay, so when the people worked on the improvement of really what can be done for improving this situation, so people worked, work study men worked on to see, by applying the critical questioning or critical examination in this way of doing the things, to explore what can be done for improving this situation. So about the another aspect I will talk about, this is the improved method only. So but how we arrived at this stage, before talking of that, let's talk about this one only, where the earlier the method which was developed, earlier recording method which was FPC of material type, that was developed. And what you have seen that there were a number of operations, transports, storage, delays, etc. And that the same thing has been shown here using the flow diagram. This is a flow diagram which shows where what is located, when the flow process chart is used in combination with the flow diagram, we get more clearer picture to see what kind of the improvement can be brought in. Okay, so here like say this is the engine storage, the block where from it was picked in, then it was brought to the 2, 3. These are the different the points, like original method is store, then is stripping bay, then degreaser, cooling, cleaning, locker, tool cabinet, etc. So these were the different things. And this is probably the degreasing the section. Degreasing is here in 3, and this 5-1 is the cleaning section. So here you can see there is a lot of movement like this. So lot of movement is taking place that we can visualize only through this kind of the diagram. And then again it is coming back and going to the 6, then 7, 8, 9, like that. So the point is when we show the different activities on the flow diagram, we can visualize the movement of man or material with the greater clarity. Okay. If you see, these are the transports which are being used. Engine is in the store. Okay, from the store engine is picked in, thereafter it uses 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 different transports, you can see. Okay, this is one. So the question is why there are so many transports before it is delivered to the stripping bay or dismantling bay where engine is to be stripped, and it covers a distance of this much. So many lifting and picking up of the things. So what is the reason behind? So the question asked is what is being done? You will simply ask that engine is picked from the store and then transported to the engine disassembling or stripping bay. Okay, this is the question. But why it is being done in 4 or 5 different steps? So the response received was like say the engine is stored in the store in such a way that the monorail crane cannot reach inside to pick up the engine in one go and deliver it at the engine stripping or disassembling bay. So a small crane has to be used first. So a small electric crane is used that it transports to the next crane, then it is unloaded to the floor and then picked up by the second crane. This is the monorail. This is one small monorail crane, and then one is first it is picked up by the small crane, then it is picked up by the monorail crane, and then it is delivered to the engine stripping bay. So the question is why it is not possible to pick the engine by the monorail itself in one go. So the response was that the engine is stored in such a way in the store that the monorail cannot ensure the access to the engine from the store, and that's why it cannot be picked in. So this was the reason. So now what they asked, what is being done is by picking of the engine by the two different cranes. One, the second, why it is being done in that way? Because monorail crane, one big crane, cannot reach inside the store. So what else can be done? The suggestion was, let us arrange the engine in the store in such a way that they are within the access of the monorail so that it can be picked in one go. Okay, so what should be done? The this was the alternative only, like what else can be done if this way of doing the thing is not perfect. So suggestion was like, let us put the engine in the store in such a way that it can be picked up by the monorail crane easily from the store. So the suggestion was, so what should be done? Like, let us implement the suggestion so that it can reduce the number of transports, and it can reduce the time being spent in number of picking and lifting and the moving the things. Okay, so that was so this was one when one set of the question on the purpose itself, okay? And then the like moving further, if you see the engine is stripped, then main components are clean and laid out. Main components are inspected for wear and tear, okay? Still the degreasing has not been done. If you see the parts carried out to the degreasing basket, then the degreasing basket loaded on the degreasing basket, then transported to the degreaser and unloaded to the degreaser and then degreased. So the, what is being done here in the first operation, okay, after the engine is stripping, that's fine, that's operation one. The second is the main component is cleaned and laid out for inspection. So when there is a grease, how the inspection will be done effectively, that is one. So this cleaning step, so what is being done, basically cleaning, and why it is being done, response is we don't know, okay. The second is why inspection at this stage, why it is being done. What is being done is inspection at this stage to see wear and tear, but why it is being done when there is a grease, it cannot be inspected properly. So why it is being done at this stage, there is no response. So in that way, it is very common in industries to see like people don't know why it is being done. The reason is sometimes some of the changes are brought in as a temporary change to deal with certain contingencies, and those changes which were brought in to deal with the contingent situations will continue even after the contingent situation is over. Even after the normalizing, those things which were not needed will continue without going back to the original method. So if we don't find any genuine response to a particular question, that becomes the genuine case for elimination. So after dismantling or stripping, the main component cleaning is not needed, because perfect cleaning after the degreasing is to be done in any case. Likewise, when there is a grease, it cannot be inspected properly, so this is also not needed. So let us do away with these two things. And after the stripping or the dismantling, let us send the parts directly to the degreasing basket. Okay, and when it is sent to the degreasing basket, again you see number of transports. So people will ask why there is so much movement. Is it possible, like after the dismantling, can it be placed in the degreasing basket directly so that it can be delivered in the degreaser? So those options are explored basically. Okay, so we'll continue to ask like this. Each and everything will be questioned and possibility will be explored to see if either it can be eliminated or some newer way of doing the thing is identified. Okay, so this is how this entire the stage of the questioning is continued. So if you see, after the questioning, they eliminated some of the steps, they simplified the way by which things are proposed to be done. So in the proposed newer method, what this did, like let us store the engines in the store in such a way that a monorail can directly pick it up from the store, okay. And then engine picked up, then transported to the stripping bay, and then engine is unloaded, and then engine is stripped. So the operation one, there is no cleaning, direct degreasing, okay, there is no inspection. So likewise, after the stripping, transported to the degreasing basket, then loaded in the degreasing basket, unloaded into the degreaser, degreased, okay. So this is the degreasing is being done, unloaded from the degreaser, and then again moved, transported to the degreaser, then loaded on the ground, allowed to cool. Okay, so this is one delay. Then transported to the cleaning benches, after that it is properly cleaned, and then all parts are cleaned, and then all parts are collected in the special tray, waiting for the transport, and then these are again moved for the final inspection purpose on the inspection platform. So by systematic analysis, challenging the different aspects related with the things which are being done, existing way. This is the existing method of doing the things. And when the critical examination was imposed, few things were eliminated, few things were simplified, and in that way the updated or proposed method was implemented, which reduced the number of activities also. So you see, the improved method had three operations, because unnecessary cleaning was eliminated. This was the cleaning, unnecessary cleaning. Similarly, one earlier there was one inspection just after the cleaning. This was also eliminated. So this inspection was also eliminated. Then the number of transports were reduced, because there is no now electric crane. Only the monorail crane is directly picking the engine from the stores and delivering it to the engine stripping bay. And likewise, so after developing the new improved method, what it led to, the reduced number of operations from 4 to 3, reduced transports from 21 to 15, reduced delays from 3 to 2, okay, reduced inspection from 1 to nil, and storage 1, that is in any case picking up from the stores only. Okay, so if you see, the distance traveled reduced from 237.5 to 150 meters, and as far as the number of activities are concerned and the distance traveled is concerned, there is a saving of 10 number of activities. So if earlier there were how many, 30 activities, and now these are 20. So number of activities reduced from 30 to 20, and distance traveled reduced from 237 to 150. Okay, 150. So there is a saving of 87 meters. So if you see, in this example, we have not incorporated the time factor. Otherwise, we could have also included the time here with each of the activity. And if the time is also included here, then that could have shown us how much saving with regard to the time is being realized through the improved method of doing the things. Okay, so as far as this engine dismantling, degreasing, cleaning, and for the inspection purpose, when the method is improved, we can see there is improvement in the flow process chart for man type. This is just another example to tell, like when we develop the flow process chart for material and for the equipment, we use the passive voices, and here we use the active voices. Okay, when the flow process chart for man type is used, like say the different activities are described, here we can put in the distance traveled or the time consumed, and these are the various symbols used for symbols showing the various activities. So let's say check the oil level. This is the inspection. Check the oil barrel location. Move to the oil barrel location. So this is the transport. Fill the mist oil into the machine. So this is the operation. To draw the raw material storage rack. Okay, this is the transport. Move to the raw material storage rack. Okay. Identify the raw material location of the required grade. This is inspection. So move to the crane location. So this is the transport. Move the crane to the, otherwise we could have said the crane is moved. Okay, and here move to the, so man is moved to the crane location. Here we could have said that the machine is filled with the mist. Okay, but here fill the mist oil into the machine. So there is a little difference in the way by which we say the things. Adjust the crane rope to hold the bundle and insert. So this is the operation. And move the raw material
to the cutting machine. Okay, so this is the transport, and remove the wire to separate the bars from bundles. This is the operation. If you see here, we have three operations and say five transports and two inspections. Okay, so this is how the main type of the FPC, the flow process chart, can be developed. How to check the feasibility of the improved method? Yes, so effectiveness or feasibility of improved method or the new method, like say whatever is being proposed, the improved method proposed, how to check that? So obviously we'll be looking for the saving in terms of the distance traveled, in terms of the time being saved in completion of the one cycle, in terms of the time means like the man or machine hours saving. Okay, and once we get the time there, we can also identify the saving in terms of the cost of material or machine or the man. So that like saving in terms of the labor cost or saving in terms of the material, then you can see the percentage change. Percentage change in the productivity. So this can be in form of like say partial productivity or total productivity depending upon our interest. Whenever a new method is developed on paper, we try to first of all assess the suitability of the proposed method with regard to the distance, time saving, or the kind of change which can be expected, and apart from that, what will be the cost of new method if it is to be implemented. So people can see directly what will be the payback time or the kind of investments need to be made. Okay, so that is about, like I have already said, you have to see that there is an economy, the safety aspects are not compromised, there is the quality aspects are not compromised, and at the same time there is a human aspects are also kept in mind while taking a decision about implementing the new or the improved method. Okay, so coming to the as far as the development of method is concerned, like I've already said so many things, when we develop a new method is based on development of the new method is based on what? Develop a new method, like just using the answer of what should be done related with the different steps which are there of a particular work cycle or of during the production of a particular component or service. So what should be done, where should it be done, okay, and then when should it be done, who should do it, and how should it be done. When we put in the answer of all these questions for all steps related with production process or procedure being adopted for like say a manufacturing of an axle, right, from the raw material to the cutting, then turning, then machine, heat treatment, then final painting, etc. So whatever the different steps are there, we have to get the solution or answers for all these questions for each of the steps associated with the production process. And once we have that, probably we'll be able to develop a new method, as I have given with the help of this example. Okay, so development and the critical examination, both are almost a similar kind of thing, because the last responses to the last question of the secondary questioning gives us the way by which new method is to be developed.